welcome to Kenneth Frankly. I'm your host, Kenneth Frank, and I'm not Josie Grothy anymore.
I'm proud of you.
I'm joined, as always, by my lovely and talented co-host, Rory.
Hi, Diesel.
What up, girl?
Hi.
How are you?
Great.
We are joined by a trio of treasures, some splendid guests. Everyone's leaning in. We've got Helen, we've got Lily, we've got Allison, also known as the Yayas.
Yaya to you.
And yeah.
Kenny, these are my friends.
Yeah, welcome. Welcome to my humble abode.
Can you guys tell Thank Kenny you. A little bit
Helen,
about...
Helen, tell me, who are you guys?
You just...
Wait, you do it.
All I just wanted to know.
Diction.
Hold on, ready?
Unique Unork.
Nope, that's not it at all.
Unique New York.
Here, take
this. Anyways, so
I
guys,
with this.
You stupid idiots. can we talk about how you decided I was your fourth?
Let me start by asking, how do y'all, the Yayas, know each other?
So
I think it's one of my parents.
One of my favorite stories is how you tell it best, how I dated you.
Allison was dating one of my closest friends from high school, and they dated for a few years.
Too long.
A little too long.
Gross.
And then they were no longer, and I kept her.
Correct. Yes. I like that.
You got her in the divorce?
I did.
So that's how...
Win!
That's how Lily and Allison came to be.
Yep.
Where did Helen come into the picture?
It's even more sorted. I love
That's
it. Continue.
A more interesting story. Helen and I share, in a nutshell, we share a terrible, awful ex-boyfriend. Side note, a different ex-boyfriend. And we decided to
that
both...
That she doesn't know about?
No, just not Helen, the what? One that Lily and I share.
Oh, different. Yeah.
Different ex.
Good.
No, two different exes of mine.
The most
But we
person.
Share... Yeah, he's the worst, but we both kicked him to the curb, and we kept each other.
Nice. Yeah.
So, moral of the story is...
There's a pattern happening.
Yeah.
So, it's like, the boy is mine.
Yeah, like, well,
Brandy
it's like
and
the... Yeah, the boy is mine.
But only if Monica and Brandy became friends in the end.
Exactly.
That's exactly correct.
And then they both kick him out.
Yeah.
That's exactly what happens in The Boy Is Mine.
Oh, in the
no,
music video?
No, but you
video?
Don't see them becoming friends after. They just, like... It's what do you want, Kenny? What do you want? Tell me what happened that.
They become.
What did I not see?
They become frenemies.
Yeah, but Elaine. They're not. We're yayas. They're not frenemies. Oh,
okay. Yeah. No, it's just yaya. It's just love.
Chicks before dicks. End of story.
And so chicks before.
So yes. So that all happened. We three became. A unit, mm-hmm. And then we decided that we were yayas. Do y'all know what yayas are?
Yeah, like the pants.
Not,
no.
not the traveling
the divine
pants
and the sisters and the yayas.
Totally separate.
Pretty much.
Are they not the same thing?
No!
Okay. Wait, so how did Rory become
no
a yaya?
Oh.
Well, we were looking for our fourth for a while.
Okay.
And nobody quite fit. We tried some
it
on.
It's so creepy every time we talk about
I know.
It.
Well, we sound
We're
beautiful.
Alluding to the American modern classic, The Craft, starring Faruza Balk,
totally.
Rachel True,
yes.
Robin Tunney.
Yes.
And Neve Campbell.
Yes.
This is what makes me feel good about myself. Like, I appreciate the story.
So I don't yeah, remember no, how Rory met them. I don't remember making the introduction.
Your Christmas party.
It was a Christmas
speak in the mic. Speak
party.
In the mic.
Oh, okay.
Speak in the mic.
The Christmas party.
What oh, I threw a Christmas party.
Yeah,
and we were decorating my Christmas tree, and you
Happy
met Rory.
Happy holidays.
Yes, and there was one particular party goer.
Happy holidays.
Who was not.
The Mary Bell.
She was singing and playing, and
no. was like cutting off way too much of the Christmas tree.
Oh, I had an unfortunate friend who butchered my Christmas tree.
We were all very upset about what was happening to this Christmas tree, and so then we went out onto Lily's porch, and
the veranda.
Yes,
the menagerie,
more like a balcony.
The veranda,
balcony, and so we were discussing, you know, the injustice that was being done to this tree. and
Edward Scissorhands.
Yes.
Yeah. But not
but as not artful. In a good way.
Not in a good way. No, no.
And then I feel like afterwards we were just like Rory.
Well, no. Afterwards these two clearly Allison and Helen clearly had a conversation and came to me one night.
No, but also joke. But I was gone for the night too. Like I was not there.
No, but it was later. It was later.
Yeah, no, I was
right.
This is beyond me.
And they were like, we feel we found our fourth Yaya. And we think it's Rory.
Wow.
And I was like, awesome. And that's...
No, but to which I was like... I'm like, earth, yeah. earth. And I'm like, why will no one else join in with me? What the fuck? I thought we were going to like conjure earth, some shit.
I know, nobody's light as a feather.
Oh, he's sorry. Sorry, Maya! And then... The guy goes out the window.
I'm sorry, what?
Freeze the ball.
The crash.
Guys, so I was just listening to a podcast. I have my Invisalign in for the first day, so I have a little bit of a...
Wait, today's your first day?
Well, like Friday, and now it's Sunday, so it's the first 48. Congrats.
Does it hurt?
The first 48. Dun, dun. no, it doesn't hurt, but it's... I'm very, like, lifty.
Oh, it's...
I'm like Cindy from the Brady Bunch.
I would think that it hurts so bad.
Mom asked me to ask you if there's any mail for the Bradys. Oh, well, I'm no, it doesn't.
That's really good.
No, it doesn't hurt. It just is. It's like a noose right over my teeth. Just like it's fine.
See, my experiences with teeth and moving teeth in a systematic order has always been painful. Mm. Yeah.
Yeah.
So I can't imagine that not being painful at all. Like even just the spacers. So they used to put these spacers in before you got real braces on, like where you would have the thing around your tooth and on your molars.
I personally thought that those were the worst.
Yeah,
actually,
right. The spacers.
Worse than braces.
So the space. Yeah, exactly. The spacers that they would put on before you had the. Is this not cool? No, is this not good? Man. Okay,
I mean,
whatever.
This isn't the best podcast I've ever heard, but that's okay. We can keep going.
Allison, shut the fuck up, would you?
So
anyways, but
sweat.
The spacers to put on the mold at the...
Molar?
Yeah, yeah. Anyways, they hurt a lot more than anything you've ever been through, and I hate you.
Fair, and thank you. Has everyone in this room had braces?
Yeah.
So,
although,
fine.
Anyway, welcome to the show. I'm so glad you guys are here. You guys, I tried to order white wine at a metal show this week. It didn't work out.
Well, who did you see?
Not so much. My friend was in a battle of the bands, and I went to see the show. And
are you still friends?
Yeah, I'm a metalhead now.
Oh,
I went up to the bar. I was like, can I have some white wine? And they were like, no, you cannot. We don't do that here. And I was like, okay, fine. So I ended up with like a...
Did they ask you to leave?
Almost. I was like, I looked so cute though. I was wearing my gay and stupid t-shirt. And, and like my oversized winter jacket, very Ariana Grande. Just like super
so
baggy
good.
And like flirty. So I was wearing...
Have you been here all night?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
All day, side to side. So I went to a metal show. And it was the worst. And now I have Invisalign, so it's been a crazy week.
I'm it's proud
been quite
of you.
A week. Thank you.
Dinky.
Yeah.
Oh. So Crystal has a recommendation for us.
Oh.
Instead of saying, or what was the? What were we asking? One of you, wenches. Where's my phone?
Wenches.
I'm so sorry,
Helen. Are you not into the headphones?
You're both looking at me like fuck you.
I don't know what you're asking.
And by both, I mean
is
all
it
of
too
you.
Much? You're not.
I know. I was just. Adding to your aesthetic.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate it.
So. All right. What are you looking for, babe?
On my phone.
Babe.
Okay. Well, another story about wine. So I was living in Texas and...
Ew, where in Texas?
Oh, I lived in Austin.
Why?
Which was... Oh, Austin was really cool, but I couldn't do it forever. But I went to this brewery.
The brewery.
And I don't drink beer. Mm. And I walked up to the bar and I said, can I have a glass of Pinot Noir? And they just looked at me like completely deadpan. I said... Can I have a glass of Pinot Noir? They said, we have red, white, and pink.
Ew.
I was like, okay, I'll have a glass of red, please. Yeah. And they literally had to like,
heard of Pinot Noir.
Yeah, like they didn't know what they meant or anything. And they had to like, blow the dust off. It was just this like,
what is I guess you could drink this.
Exactly.
Guys, do you want to hear my wine joke?
Yeah.
It's a Kenny original and no one ever laughs. You guys might be the first. What's a cat's favorite type of wine?
What?
Meow.
Is that so bad? Is that the stupidest joke you've ever
heard?
Meow. Because it's not. I think the joke is that it's not an average cat meow. It's more like the weird, like pregnant weird, cat like, outside at late at night, like, or like the one that doesn't know where he is. Like that's what that
patches
cat,
of fur missing.
Yeah. Meow. Like, but we've all heard that cat sound, right?
I make it.
That reminds me of in the Lady of the Tramp when they're in the pound.
I love that sexy dog. That's the best sexy cartoon dog.
Okay.
You're a scoundrel.
Perfect segue, because we just all went to see Beauté and the Beast.
Oh, perfect.
And my initial takeaway from that movie was they really leaned into the bestiality portion of the movie, didn't they? Did you agree? It was like, not only was she like super horny for this beastie beast, but also like the duster was a like a swan that was fucking the candlestick. Like, it was very like animal or
there
man.
There were some questionable acts. I mean.
We've been doing this for 4 months. You need to.
There were some questionable acts, but like.
So guys,
I hate you.
I might be against the grain on this. I did not enjoy that movie.
I didn't not enjoy it, but I didn't love it.
Is that a double negative?
Yes.
That's funny because I recall turning to my right
and you
then
were,
seeing you bawling your eyes out. Yes, you absolutely were.
You guys were
hands over your mouth,
ridiculous.
Sobbing.
That's not bawling.
Ridiculous.
Lily, a tear. Allison, did you see a tear?
Okay, well, I was too busy crying to notice if your tears were there.
So, and Rory was crying too. She was sitting next to me. She was stippling.
Okay.
Helen,
get off me!
Helen and I are the two rational adults who said...
Yeah, but crying doesn't mean you like the movie.
I'm sorry, you don't have feelings.
I bawled my eyes out of Turner and Hooch, and I will forever hate Tom Hanks.
Oh, okay. That's fair.
Wow, okay. Like, well, that's great. A whole like, other topic feelings. For another day.
The reason that I didn't cry is probably because I had questions about those extra songs that they put in.
Mm-hmm.
Because they didn't add anything.
Nope.
They made it more confusing.
Correct.
They were unnecessarily overly emotional.
Agree. Yeah.
And
very melodramatic.
And kids wouldn't even fucking like them. They're fucking boring.
Yeah. Like, exactly.
If you're going to put them in because there's a lull, maybe I'll get that.
But like, they already figured that out when they put the movie out the first time.
Right. It was very much the junior version of Little Mermaid that I saw where they added extra songs.
Mm.
But like,
it was,
why?
But it was just to give. Like that kid that didn't have a part.
A little bit.
But like, what is the point if you're doing a major motion picture?
And I played Maurice in our production and he did not sing. However, I have the strongest voice.
It would have been a big deal if he sang.
Well, I feel like
he should have sang. That song actually should have been part of the original.
That was a cute little
song. Do you know what I had a question about? Mm-hmm. How was there this castle and a prince? Mm-hmm. Not so far away from the village, and nobody knew about this beast.
Uh-oh. I will interject.
Guys, just for the record, Allison has seen this movie twice.
Yeah.
So she's our resident expert. Mm-hmm. On
she's got the PhD when it comes to this movie.
I really do. And in the beginning, they made it
Allison says, let me feel this.
Yeah. Let me answer this question. In the beginning, they made it very clear that they knew everything that was happening, and they also stated that enchantress wiped away the memory of the castle.
True. That is true. I
and
remember
the beast
that. That is absolutely
from
true.
The villagers. Like they were like, just in case you all have any questions, we're gonna answer them right now. Yeah,
this is
very
what you
true.
Need to know.
Mm-hmm.
Now
it's true.
Now here's my retort. Perhaps they did that Did my adult ass notice that? No. Is a 6-year-old gonna fucking pick up on that?
Absolutely not.
But I guess they don't give a shit. Although, that brings me to the next point. What's important about this movie? The character, Belle. Is Emma Roberts the most pitiful
Belle? It's not Emma Roberts. Emma Watson.
Emma Watson. They're all the fucking same.
No, they're not.
They are. They are.
They're all totally the bling are. Ring.
They are
whatever.
All the same. They are all the same.
Is Emma Watson not the most pitiful, dreary Belle you've ever seen? Yeah. Like, she is not good in this movie.
All right. Again.
There's something strange.
About your work.
No, but true. But I will say, again, since I am the expert.
Right. Seen it twice.
Mm-hmm, yeah. Mm-hmm. The first time I was definitely disenchanted by Emma Watson.
Roberts.
Yeah.
Roberts.
I had to take a pause. Second time around.
So did she, and then back out of this film.
Yeah.
And make a better decision for herself, right? And for the world.
Well, that's a whole but anyway, the second time around, I was definitely more satisfied. But a whole nother thing, and that this could be a potential segue that you could take or not, but she,
I think telling me that it's a segue negates the effectiveness of the segue.
Yeah.
Just an opinion.
All right, fine. But small little tidbit for you. Okay.
Give it to
is
me.
She turned down the role in La La Land.
She should have taken the role in La La Land because she had the voice for that. She had the voice for that. She had the hipster, smarmy, I can't sing, but I guess I can sing. She could have done that flawlessly.
Which irritated me about this movie, because specifically, I was like, I feel like we should have dubbed over Emma Watson's voice.
Mm.
With
the
ours?
Singing pieces.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Like, yeah, like Rory, you would have been a great, you know.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Her name is
Belle. Cop talk, keep talking.
Did you say
but you know what I'm saying? Like...
Y'all.
Y'all, I don't know what that's I said. All. Keep talking.
Oh, wait, continue.
No, that's...
No, but keep talking about how I would do a great
What
job.
Are your thoughts? Helen, overall thoughts on the movie, go.
Thoughts on the movie. I thought that the parts that had Gaston in them were way, like, more family-friendly. Like I had, like, a fun time with those. Yeah. Whereas... In the original Disney movie, when I was a child, I was always like freaked out by those moments because I was like, "Oh, like these are like a bunch of crazy people like yelling in a hall."
Mm-hmm. That's funny because I, watching this, I was like, "They are glorifying a sexual assailant. Like this guy is like a deviant, violent stalker
that's
creep."
Like, that's kind of what I got too.
But,
yeah.
My God, did you notice him stabbing people?
No.
He like legitimately stabbed people during that song.
No, I did not know.
Okay,
that.
Again.
I also did not pick up on the gay moment with Lumiere.
Okay,
or
that's
whatever.
A, that's an
is.
Interesting point. Well, okay, so
Lumiere,
so
the other guy,
yeah,
LeFou.
But the first time I watched it, again, I've seen it twice. First time,
drinking game. Every time Allison says she's,
I didn't notice the stabbing. So
yeah, I did
again,
not notice
if you
stabbing.
Haven't seen the movie yet, keep an eye out for that.
Okay.
But you're not the first person I've talked to who didn't really pick up on the whole gay.
No, I didn't at all.
LeFou vibe.
Which is funny because the director was like, "Oh, this is the first Disney movie ever. We're having a gay moment." And then they were like, "Oh wait, maybe it's not that."
Okay.
Gay.
Well, like
the
he
guy
was like,
"Was in a dress."
Well, no.
No, it was supposed to be LeFou's attraction to
sure,
Gaston.
But there's that. But then at the very end of the movie, for like a sec, the kid that they dressed up in the dress and he was all like,
yeah,
I'm happy
about
that
it.
I'm in a dress.
Yeah, yeah.
Him and LeFou started dancing.
Oh, I didn't notice that.
Right at the end.
That's cute. I did not notice that.
So they were dancing.
Well, I'm glad we have someone who has seen the movie twice here to really dig deep. Lily, overall thoughts on the film? How much did you bawl because you loved it so much?
I did not bawl. It was sad in the end.
Lily, I saw tears running.
I did not have any tears.
Staining your shirt.
My black shirt. Don't stain.
I saw tears, buckets of tears.
I like animals, okay? I like it when they're not hurt anymore.
Okay.
Appropriate.
I like animals, okay.
Get it?
I thought it was slow. I thought it was really slow. Mm. I thought the tempo on the songs were slow.
Agreed.
It bored me.
Yeah. And you know what? You know what else? In terms of the overall vibe of it, it was lit very dark.
Yeah, it was too emo.
Very dark. Yeah. It was hard to see anything that was going on.
She was emo too. No wonder they get along.
The Beast was like specifically like, oh, like, you know, no one likes me. Everyone's against me. Like,
yeah, you know what? His character didn't change either.
His character's a non-issue and always has been.
No, he was a little bitch of a prince and now he's a little bitch of a beast and nobody likes me.
And show up and she's like, okay, I'll like, you know, help you out.
There's something strange and so unsure, and there still is.
Yeah. Da, da,
da. And you know what? I really miss Angela Lansbury. I'm not gonna lie.
Me too.
I was like craving her voice to sing it.
Emma Thompson. Going back to the other Emma, not Roberts, Watson, whatever the fuck one it is.
Who?
What the fuck was with her voice? Like, it was her inflections were weird. Her singing was weird. It was so soulless. Like, I did not feel it at all.
It was too recorded.
Also, yeah.
Why are they all British?
Yeah.
Right. Like, I
that was killing me. Why you're in France? Like, this is about France. Why are you speaking with
I'll
a British
give them
accent,
the fairy tale
bitch.
British accent. That's they have a pass.
It's so
that's
peculiar.
Fine. But the just the tone of her voice was just and everything she said. I was like, ugh,
yeah,
it's not good.
I'm so strange. I like books.
Yeah. Allison, overall thoughts, opinions?
Oh, okay.
After having seen it
as the resident
twice.
Expert.
Twice.
As the expert. Twice. I liked it more the second time. I did. In a just simple statement, I liked it better the second time.
Okay. I'm going to give Beauty and the Beast 2 out of 5 Emma Watson's eyebrows. So I have a question for everyone. If you were in the spirit of Beauty and the Beast, if you were an animated inanimate object, what would you be?
Can I start?
Please.
Can I be this picture of you and Matthew?
I don't think you are a huge portrait of me and my then boyfriend, now husband. I don't think that's you. I think there's something else that captured
your... She's the wardrobe.
No.
She's the wardrobe.
That's cute. No, what are you really, Rory?
Yeah, what are you really?
I'm the sound of seltzer.
Oh, Jesus.
I am Christ. Really pretty wrapping paper that you feel bad opening.
Oh, yes. Rory, that is absolutely correct. Ding, ding, ding. I think
like
that's perfect
I wrap
for you.
It real nice. Mm-hmm. You feel bad about opening it, and it makes me feel good watching you ruin it.
I like it. I like it. Yeah, you are. Wow. You are expensive wrapping paper. Allison, what are you?
Oh boy, pressure's on. I mean, watching the movie, since I've made it pretty obvious, I
have seen it twice and love it.
And
we'll see it again.
No,
and know
never.
Everything about it.
And ever.
And actually,
and
you're
ever.
Dating one of the gaffers, and it's this whole thing.
Oh my God,
but you don't
want
to make it serious.
<That's> not supposed to tell anybody. Lily pointed it out in the beginning that I would be like Lumiere. Obviously, I could agree. Mm. But do I feel like I would be a candelabra?
No.
You know what?
No, you're always smoking. You've got...
Yeah, I'm smoking. I'm hot. I light up a room.
You were
so
illuminating.
Yeah.
I see your Lumiere, and I raise you a cigarette lighter in a car.
No.
No? Mm.
No. Maybe a grill lighter.
No, she's more like Lumiere because she
or extra long matches for like your fireplace.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
All right. Moving on.
That, like the matches that Helen got for us for Christmas.
Oh yeah.
In our stockings that were extra long and wooden. They were wonderful.
That's adorable.
Totally.
Yeah, I know. It was really sweet.
Mm-hmm.
Lily, what are you? Animated, inanimate object.
You're your bunny rabbit.
Shaker.
I don't know. I'm jerking something off, apparently. What am I?
Your silver bunny rabbit
I'm a booze infused rabbit.
Yeah.
Nice.
Done.
Rabbit. That's rabbit. Actually pretty. Yeah. Accurate. I like
that. But in,
yesterday,
but
a, rabbit.
The problem is that a rabbit is an animal, so it's not inanimate, and so that.
No, it's a shaker with an animal head.
What?
Yep.
Like a salt shaker?
No, it's a beverage shaker.
Like a bar. Oh, okay, like a martini shaker.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay. In the shape of a rabbit.
Yeah, it's lovely.
Okay. So you're a rabbit.
Thanks, Dad.
Okay. Helen, rat. What are you? Animated, inanimate object.
So currently, I feel the most... Okay.
Close. Closer than you think it should be.
Currently, I feel the most kindred spirit with that...
Penguin.
Yeah.
Benjamin.
Doobie doobie doo.
Benjamin the Penguin. I bought him at Newbury Comics when I was a smooth 16 years old.
Whoa, really?
Yeah. He's been with me this whole time.
Wow.
You did know me then. Wow. Anyway, so if I was an animated inanimate object, I think I would probably be a yo-yo.
Ooh.
I think I'm a yo-yo.
Like in terms of
just like high drama and like fun, but like sort of sad too.
Like, what's he gonna do this time?
And it's like, oh, but
is he gonna walk the dog or is he gonna like
he's so right, back what's and the forth? Bounce. He's like fucking ridiculous.
But also like when in the wrong hands, I can be a real flop. You know what I mean?
Yep.
Like,
Wah.
Like yeah. And I'm like plastic and pink. And I'm like corny, but like very transparent.
Oh, I was gonna give it 3 out of 5, or 3 out of how many? 4 candy bracelets.
Thank y'all. Dang I'm bringing them back.
Snap bracelets are next.
Oh yeah.
Oh
I like that.
Yeah.
What? We should have snap chokers, right? Because there were snap bracelets, and our chokers are coming back. I think a snap choker. Don't. Take it. It's mine. Trademark. Like, stay away.
No, I will model those for you.
You will?
Yes.
Whoopsh. Yeah, I think that's such a cool idea.
My neck.
Look how cool I am. We're putting my choker on.
Yeah.
My neck hurts.
It's amazing.
It's me.
So, guys, we're about to enter the Hot Topic section of the show.
Oh my god.
Rachel Dolezal is back.
Yeah.
I would not be making fun of Rachel Dolezal if she wasn't back in the media promoting a goddamn book. She's ridiculous. We all know Rachel Dolezal is the not black person who was.
You mean the blonde black?
Yeah.
Naturally blonde, but I'm black.
Cashing in on blackness when you're not black sounds like a pretty fucking white people thing for me to do. but whatever, that's fine.
Oh, man.
So she was on the Today Show. She was promoting her new book, and she was, by the way, the book's called In Full Color, which for Rachel Dolezal means like all the spectrum of white.
Oh, like, oh my god.
Mayonnaise, dust, scrambled egg whites, tissue, wet off-white. Tissue, all the full colors. And so Samantha Guthrie on the Today Show asked her why she identifies as a member of the African American community. And Rachel's response was, quote, "I don't identify as African American. I identify as black. I'm part of the Pan African diaspora." Bitch! Like, are you fucking kidding me?
What does that mean? What is that?
She went on to say, even though race is a social construct and we've acknowledged this in academia and in science. Oh, okay. Excuse me, Rachel. There's still a line. There's still a line drawn in the sand. There are still our sides. Politically, there's a black side and a white side, and I stand unapologetically on the black side. Okay, I get that. I understand that. I stand with my own internal sense and values. I stand with my sons. I stand with my sister. I also stand there really with greater cause, blah, 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 challenging the myth of white supremacy.
You guys seem sold.
Then, Helen, do you have something to say? Then in another interview, Rachel comes out as bisexual. The poor bisexuals, they have no community. And then she Rachel's like, I'm that's me. Like, no.
Well, she just wants to be the picture person for something.
Everything.
Yeah.
So she identifies as Pan-African she identifies as Pan-African pro-black bisexual mother activist artist. And since labeling all of that is too long, she prefers to use the term trans black because it's quicker.
So is that like, are you transitioning to black?
She
is that the meaning of trans
black? If there are two things that Rachel Dolezal is not, it is trans and it is black. She is not those things. You don't just get to say it for your convenience that I'm trans. For it's just easier. I'm trans and black, okay? Bitch, what the fuck?
Well, doesn't trans mean you're transitioning?
Yes.
So how does one transition to another
Except unless you're Michael Jackson.
I was going to say.
I wasn't going to go there, but
no.
Well done.
I read that she's also a unicorn. And a Mormon and a Holocaust survivor.
She's
aren't we all?
She's
because aren't we all everything? I'm trans black too.
She's led a tough life.
Girl, whatever. Anyway, yeah. Thank you, Rachel Dolezal. Now I can truly embrace my pan hyphenating omnidirectional identity.
Like, what does pan mean exactly?
Pan expanding all, like all encompassing. Like pansexual is pansexual and bisexual are almost. Not the same, but they can be used interchangeably.
What was Earth before all the continents broke apart?
I don't know. Gaia? I don't know.
No, it was Gaia. Pan, nice. Pan something. It was Pan something.
Labyrinth.
Pan America. Pan Asia?
No.
Pan America.
Pan cakes?
No, it was not Pan America.
Pan.
Conscience. Prides?
Yeah, anyway. Can a gay-sounding voice cost you your job, people? I don't know. Are gay men and lesbians turned down for prominent jobs and paid significantly less because of their voices? A just-published study in the Archives of Sexual Behavior insists the answer is yes!
Yeah, yeah! Phenomenal!
The study presented a heterosexual sample group with a handful of photos and audio snippets of gay, lesbian, and straight speakers, whom participants in an earlier study claimed had prototypical gay and straight voices. I don't know what that means, but whatever.
What's a prototypical gay/straight voice?
I think a prototypical gay voice is what I have.
What's a prototypical straight voice?
It's a little more like deep.
Do you have a prototypical straight voice?
Yeah, do you guys want to go to like...
No, we totally do. So what was
this? How I find out that I'm bi? You, is that I don't have a prototypical straight voice?
No, you do. You've been profiled as straight for a long time now, and I'm very sorry.
Yeah.
I know.
I'm sorry that you have to...
We've been treating you wrong.
Use that label. Shouldn't be used.
No, but so when I worked for my last company, when we would do advertising for our like annual campaign, we would do like casting based on we want an ethnic voice. We want a like a racially ambiguous voice.
Well, I'm
like,
sure we get hired because I'm a gay person as opposed to in spite of the fact that I'm a gay person.
I hope so.
In Massachusetts? Like, yeah, it makes, like, I'm the token gay in my company, right?
That's wonderful.
I mean, at least I have a job, right? But think of, like, in Texas, people like me aren't getting the jobs I get.
That's true.
Right?
Right? Yeah.
So, in this study, based solely on the timbre of the voices, the participants were asked to evaluate each speaker's competency level. Oh my God. Would they be suitable applicants for a fake CEO position was the question. Would they, what would be a fair salary? And then they were also asked to come up with the number that they would pay these people based on the samples of their voice.
Did these people know what like the typical CEO makes?
For their area, probably, yeah. Or like what they would gauge is like, that's
so they know like what's comparable.
Yeah, sure. So overall, the participants associated heterosexual sounding voices with masculine traits and wound up assigning them higher competency levels and better salaries. Meanwhile, lesbian candidates were... I can't believe that. Meanwhile, lesbian candidates were associated with a lack of femininity and received far lower evaluations than their straight peers. One notable limit to the research is that the study solely used Italian subjects. So this is like maybe that's different in Italy, but I feel like...
No.
This just seems silly.
Yeah.
It's like Joey Tribbiani.
Like, everything he does is a joke. So
do they
like,
measure masculinity? I guess the question is, do they measure masculinity in a different scale in Italy than they do in America?
Yeah, it's got to be somewhat
masculinity
different.
Masculinity in Italy is a little different than in America.
Absolutely, yeah.
Is it? I've never been there. Oh, yeah. Tell me all about it.
A lot of sexual harassment. Much worse, okay. In my opinion.
Gaston style.
A little bit.
Yeah, okay.
And they love their mothers.
Ew.
No one drinks like Gaston.
I cannot relate.
No one sings like Gaston.
No one.
What else?
Something.
Taunts and assaults.
Something like Gaston.
Very, very good. Very, thank you. Very good.
That should have been Trump's song when he came out for inauguration.
And yes, I'm in tune.
I think we found Trump's song.
I like that.
Yeah.
Ugh, gross.
Guys,
I want to puke.
Speaking of guess who's back? Guess who's back? Guess who's back?
Back in town?
Trading Spaces is coming back to TLC. So, little known fact, the host of the show, Paige Davis, was actually named Mindy.
Minnie?
Mindy.
Mindy.
So, her name was Mindy Paige Davis. But then she got married to a guy, and his last name was Paige. So her real name is
Mindy Page Page.
Mindy Page Davis Page.
That's kind of awesome.
Trading Spaces was my life in high school. Was it not yours?
Oh my God.
It was really the introduction.
I never saw it.
What?
Never saw it.
Oh my God. This was our life.
It was like pre HTTV, what it is now. It was like.
What channel was it on?
TLC.
Yes.
It was the introduction network to like cheap renovation shows. They were still trying to find the format of like
I was more
cheap
of a
reality
this old house
TV.
Gal.
Shut up. Just stop.
It was like red.
What's wrong with this old house?
Red nothing green. Except it's is that red fun green with no this old house?
It's like PBS.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Red Green was the host, right? No. He did something else.
No.
Anyway. So Trading Spaces. This is what they would do. They would take two neighbors and they would pair them with each set of neighbors would get a designer.
So me and you, right? We would switch houses.
Awesome.
And we would
good,
be like,
I wanted to.
So like you and Rory would paint a room in my house, redecorate a room in my house.
Or more
and
than
one me,
room.
And then me and Matthew
sometimes
would go and paint
house,
a room in
much
Rory's house. Yeah. Well, it was more like a room and a half sometimes.
So what? Do you know these people or are they strangers?
They're neighbors.
But do they know each other?
Yes.
Yeah.
So they know each other.
To
they've
various
been in
degrees
each other's houses, yes. So they kind of get each other.
They know each other
they
enough to be like,
to
hey, do you want to be on Trading Spaces
right
together?
Exactly.
You know what I mean? So like, to various degrees.
Yeah.
And then they each team gets a designer and $1,000, which even in 2001 was not a lot of money.
No.
So they ended up making these hideous fucking makeovers.
With terrible built-ins.
They never looked good.
Wait, no. They had $1,000 to do the...
The room, including
that's
furniture.
Like the paint.
Including furniture.
You can't even go to TJ Maxx or Home Goods or something and get a decent set of
so home. I fell down...
But I think they could have. If they, like... So if they had the, like, everything at the disposal that we have now, I feel like they could have done pretty well. Because $1,000, like... Redo my room with $1,000, it'll look like a masterpiece.
I don't know. I mean, these were like living rooms, master bedrooms, with an all new like headboard, for instance, or like dressers. Like for $1,000, it's not happening.
Yeah. Go.
So I fell down a deep YouTube K-hole of like the terrible Trading Spaces results. There, one motherfucker put glued hay all over the walls. It was texture. It was literally fucking pieces of straw and hay on the wall. It was really bad.
I would have flipped out.
And so like
I would have lost it.
And the people that they do a big reveal at the end of the weekend. So keep in mind, these people have worked 48 hours basically nonstop.
I mean,
in their neighbor's house.
You have to live with these people after you're done.
In their neighbor's house for 48 hours, slaving away to like make this place look nice. And then it's like, oh, now you get to go. You're exhausted emotionally and physically. And let's bring you into your new living room. Bah, ta-da! There's fucking straw all over your fucking walls. Are you kidding me? No one is here for that. But the lady was actually very calm. She was like, I'm gonna have to take this down. Like, this is not gonna work. But so another little known fact about Trading Spaces, Paige Davis was not the original host.
No, she wasn't. I knew this.
The first host was Alex McLeod.
Yes,
she was there for a season and a half.
Yes, and she was and we We fought for months to get her back.
We wanted Alex McLeod back.
We weren't Alex fucking McLeod? Around.
She was this like...
Pay attention,
she was this smoky-voiced, husky-eyed, cool host of Trading Spaces she before it awesome. Blew up. She was so cool. She was down to earth. We loved her.
And then all of a sudden...
She Here comes was Mindy Page Davis Page!
And she was all... Super stupid.
Hi.
I'm Spunk, and I'm like, what's the Lisa Lapinelli from Real Housewives? That's who I am. And this is my hairstyle. Nah.
Nailed it. so Alex McLeod.
That was her.
Lisa Rinna is who you're thinking of.
Thank you.
Okay, I was like, which Lisa?
Lisa Lapinelli is that stand-up comedian that does the roasts.
Oh my god! So Alex McLeod, original host. By I always way, felt bad for her because she what?
Fix that for me, would you?
I will.
Thanks.
Alex McLeod, I felt bad because they sort of like kicked her out right before the show became this big thing,
right?
And I was like. Oh, poor Alex. She jumped to a little show on Fox called Joe Millionaire, which maybe you guys watched back in the day.
Loved that show.
Joe Millionaire. They tricked a gaggle of women into thinking that this man was a babe and rich.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But he happened to just be a babe.
Yeah.
And then at the end, it was like, is this true love? I'm actually not rich. Is that cool? Like...
And they were like, bye, bro.
Yeah, like, whatever. But if she chose to keep him, they each get $100,000 or whatever. Whatever. Lame. Fucking whatever.
Not.
But Alex McLeod hosted that. And I was like, okay, come up. Come on. Let's see if you have a career. And then she disappeared. And I was like, where's Alex McLeod?
Fix it.
Where did she go? And I always felt bad for her. I felt like she really missed her, you know, Nina.
Her time.
Her calling.
Santa Maria.
Yeah.
Whatever the fuck those were.
The Nina, the Pinta, and the Santa Maria.
So I did a quick Goog. And I looked her up. She lives in one of the most expensive houses in America. She's married to a food entrepreneur. 53,000 square feet, 9 bedrooms, 24 bathrooms, listed for $48 million. It has 5 levels underground.
Alex McLeod?
Alex McLeod.
Wait.
So first of all, 5 levels is she on the new DuckTales?
No, she should be, though.
Okay. How?
Her entrepreneur husband is like super rich. So rich that when you Google his net worth, it's blocked. Google's like, we're not going to say. So he's friends with Google. And Google, he owns Google. I mean, he doesn't honestly own Google.
Yeah, but friends
Google
own,
is like, okay, whatever you say,
sir. Friends own Google.
Yeah.
Yikes.
5 levels underground. It has its own. It has its own chapel. It has pools, a spa. This place is ridiculous.
I like those things, but not the...
So guess who I don't feel sorry for anymore? Alex McLeod!
Fuck you, Alex McLeod.
I have a quick game to play with everybody. It's called Rapid Fire, and we're going to go one at a time, and we're going to compare answers. Allison's going to go first because she seems the most trepidatious about it.
It's really fun. You'll love it.
So... This is a series of rapid fire questions, and you are going to quickly tell me whether it's totally, which means, yeah, cool, I like it, approve.
You have to define that.
Or lame, nope, don't like it, disagree, get rid of it in my life.
You can also say turtly for totally if that's what you prefer.
Got it.
Do you want to hand Allison the mic? So this is a new version of the rapid fire. This is Sarah Bernardo's list. Shout out Sarah, friend of the pod. Are you ready? And you're going to go as quick as possible. Try not to think about it too hard.
Boy.
Okay?
Okay.
Ready? Staring contests. Totally or lame?
Totally.
General strikes.
General strikes?
Mm-hmm.
Lame.
Pizza.
Totally.
My pants.
What are those? Like a gray lavender type color?
Yeah, they're like a gray Uniqlo stretch.
Mm-hmm. Yep, totally.
The fiduciary rule?
Lame?
I don't know what it is. Dyson cordless vacuums.
That's wrong.
Totally.
Surprise visits.
I want to say totally.
Making prints of photos that you've taken.
Lame?
Toilet training cats.
Totally.
Skiing.
Totally.
Retirement.
Totally.
Paper cuts.
Lame.
Brooklyn.
Totally.
Mickey Mouse.
Totally.
DIY home repair.
Lame.
Taking a bath in your tub right now.
It's lame.
Outside shoes off.
Totally.
Baby alive.
Totally.
The New York Times.
Ugh, lame.
401ks.
Definitely get one.
401ks.
Mm-hmm.
Totally.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Yay.
Thank you. Lily, are you ready?
That was hilarious. Ready. Thank you.
3, 2, 1.
Go.
3, 2, 1, go. Staring contest.
Totally.
General strikes.
Lame.
Pizza.
Totally.
My pants.
Totally.
The fiduciary rule.
Don't know what it means.
Dyson cordless vacuums.
Fuck yeah. Sorry, totally.
Surprise visits.
For you?
Probably lame.
Making prints of photos that you've taken.
I have to do it. Wait, do I have to do it?
No.
Yeah.
If she does it, totally.
I said lame and I didn't mean to. So could she say totally for me?
No takes.
Totally if Allison does it for me.
Okay.
Got
then
it.
Totally.
Got it.
Fine. Toilet training cats.
Totally.
Skiing.
Lame.
Retirement.
Totally.
Paper cuts.
Stupid.
Brooklyn. Yes.
Awesome.
Mickey Mouse.
Stupid.
DIY home repair.
I did. I what? What? I got yelled at.
DIY home repair.
Willie, hurry up!
I'm contorted in my brain.
DIY home repair.
All right, you hired somebody to paint your fucking vanity in your bathroom.
All right,
lame.
Well, I'm lame.
Anyway, pour me some wine.
Yeah.
Taking a bath in your tub right now.
Since I had cleaners come today and totally. Clean my place. Yeah. Totally.
Outside shoes off.
Totally.
Baby alive.
Totally.
New York Times.
Totally.
401ks.
Totally.
Thank you.
Darling.
Helen, you ready to play?
Yes.
I can take that.
Thank you.
Totally if it's cool, lame if it's not, as quick as you can.
And
totally
it's the same.
It's
the same question. So, go.
Staring contests.
Totally.
General strikes.
Closer.
Totally.
Pizza.
Totally.
My pants.
Totally.
The fiduciary rule.
Totally.
Dyson cordless vacuums.
Eh.
Surprise visits.
Extra eh.
Making prints of photos that you've taken.
Totally.
Toilet training cats.
No.
You're supposed to say lame.
Lame.
Skiing.
Lame.
Retirement.
You have to.
That's not the question, is it?
No.
I like how she's no.
Totally no. Or lame.
Paper cuts.
Yeah.
Yuck.
Unless it's to someone you really dislike, then it's awesome.
Brooklyn.
I guess. No. No.
Mickey Mouse.
What's the opposite of totally?
Lame.
Lame. Lame.
DIY home repair. DIY home repair.
Lame.
Taking a bath in your tub now.
Lame.
Outside shoes off.
Lame.
I think the inflection. I think really outside shoes off. Baby alive.
Lame.
New York Times.
Lame.
401ks.
Lame.
Wow.
Oh my god.
We got
I don't think we've ever had such dissenting opinions.
We've got a lot.
She took such a turn. The answer to everything in the beginning was totally. And then the answer to everything at the end was lame.
No, what's the opposite of totally?
Lame.
Lame.
Episode 19. What's the opposite of totally? Are you guys ready for a homo moment?
Yes. Yeah. Always.
Homo moment. Homo moment. Homo Homo moment. Every week, I invite Rory into the world of complete homosexuality by introducing her to a gay slang term, word, phrase, event, person, place, thing, gaga, yes, queen. Yes, God.
More.
The homo moment this week is fish.
I know that.
You do? Does everyone else know that?
No. What's that?
In terms of gay slang, what does fish mean?
I don't think it's a good thing. I don't know.
In the structure of the patriarchy, it's a good thing.
A
clinger?
No.
That'd be cute.
Do you be
though.
Like, oh, he's fishy.
He's fishy.
No, can I say it?
Yeah, Rory, do you know?
It means passing. It means like passing for a girl.
In drag and trans communities.
Like if you're fishy, like you the phrase look fishy, like, I can't tell you weren't a girl.
The fishy implies that you are very feminine in appearance.
I love this term. Yeah.
So you try to use it
you're
in a
welcome.
Sentence today. Yeah, that was a quick and easy one.
Great. I'm glad I knew.
Yeah, yay! I have no listener questions. Excuse me. I have a migraine. Would you mind just... Guys, Allison. So my back was to her. So can you guys tell me exactly what's happening?
Yeah. Can you guys explain all of this? Because it was phenomenal, but I feel like it could be
even better.
Because
her back was to us. So was she turning around and looking at us?
Oh, yeah.
Like a lot?
Like a lot.
Like distracted from her happy family and their happy pizza time.
Were we being ridiculous? Like,
we were loud and laughing, right? But
we were
like,
laughing.
Guys, we were not guys. Being like,
we weren't grotesque. Swearing.
No.
We weren't talking about inappropriate topics.
We were talking about my friend's problem, mm-hmm. and we were reading texts.
Yeah.
Like, we weren't saying anything
fine.
Inappropriate.
Let me set the stage.
Nah.
My girls and I rolled deep into Otto Pizza after seeing a fantabulous matinee. $7 a pop, by the way, I owe you. Beauty and the Beast. We were living, we were loving, we had smuggled in some wine. We were a little tipsy. We said, let's get some carbs in our bellies. Let's have a little tinkle. Let's have a pizza. Let's have a slice. We sat down, jovial. Lively, happy,
jovial.
Sunday, lively. Sun is shining, 50 degrees, spring, finally. And who is this woman who, from seemingly out of nowhere, because she's upstage, my upstage.
She didn't like us.
And she walked over to our table and said, excuse me. She didn't say, I have a migraine. She said, I get migraines. So could you just, bitch, is this preemptive? Is this preventative maintenance? I get migraines, so could you just, it's like, no, you don't get to control the volume of a group of people at a pizza place on a Sunday afternoon.
No.
It's aggressive.
Bitch. And like, we were just having like the most innocent good time.
We really were.
We were not being obnoxious.
I have been obnoxious on plenty of occasions.
So many occasions.
And this was not that bad.
I don't know
so
anything.
Many.
I don't know anything about being obnoxious. So. But so when we got up to leave, she started in our faces clapping.
Yeah.
Like this petty.
Well, that's when.
No. Before that, she
came
was.
She came over to me and she was like, I will be speaking to both of you.
Wait, say again in the mic.
Hold on.
She said, from the restaurant.
The waitress.
Yeah, the waitress came over and she said, you know, you both are at fault currently, and I will be speaking to both of you. But she made it a point, I thought, to point out that they were being
the instigators.
Yes.
Because who saw the lady ask the waitress, like, can you go talk? And the waitress or the other guy was like,
oh, I didn't see that. No, I saw her go to her husband.
Oh,
and she,
you go talk to them. And he's like, nah, bitch.
There was a lot of arms and finger pointing. And she told her husband to go. And the guy reached for his beer and a slice of pizza and just shook his head no.
See, this is the thing.
What the fuck is the point?
Like I told y'all. She was getting her life from this non-drama. She was intimidated by a group of people having a good time and laughing and being a little too loud. And she's going to talk about this all week, and you're going to be the devils. And she's going to tell all of her little friends at, like, you know, stitching club or whatever. I don't know. What do fucking old white ladies do? Bowl? I don't fucking know.
Book club.
Yeah. Girl, I have a book club too. But we only read female authors and we keep it queer. So.
Of course.
But so I'm just saying, you guys have your entire lives ahead of you, as do I. This woman has nothing better to do than to interrogate and, like, try to intimidate.
Well, I love how she tried to make it about, like, them setting an example for their children.
It's and like, then, lady, you're being petty as fuck. Well, if that's the example you're trying to set.
Obnoxious. You gotta be kidding me. Come on.
Poor kids. God know, bless them.
They were seriously actually fine.
They were having a ball.
The kids were chilling. They're like, this auto is great. I'm having a great time. I got my little Diet Coke. I got my Sprite Zero.
And again, if we were having an inappropriate conversation, unless that might be a different thing.
Conversation was about.
But that's the thing. Because we were talking about gays, is that why she was like, not in front of my kids?
As soon as I started talking about the situation that I was expressing of a friend, he was going through a breakup.
Yeah, yeah.
I said it was two males. I probably said his boyfriend.
Right.
And she was like,
not around my kids.
But I'm sorry, but like, you're in Arlington.
Opinions? Oh, Jesus Christ. You're lucky that's empty, girl. You're lucky.
One.
You should know you should never let a Yaya have a stemmed wine glass. We don't do well.
Guys, oh my God. Speaking of which, so I don't know how familiar you are with my social media presence. Probably not very. But I have been going to a sassy hip hop class every Wednesday night for the past couple months.
Helen knows about this.
You do? I do. Why do you know about it?
She's seen the videos.
Oh, okay. Because I'm amazing, right? Yeah.
Exactly. Dirt.
Because I'm basically Michael Jackson, Britney Spears rolled up into one. Yes.
Go.
In their prime.
Yeah. Stop. Go. Stop. Go. Stop. Go.
So Facebook.
I feel like
message.
We're listening to Rory having sex.
Stop. Go. Stop. Go. Stop. Go. Stop. 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 Go. 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 sorry.
Continue.
So the instructor posted on Facebook, guys, I'm sorry, we're not going to have class for the next few weeks at least. I stepped on a broken piece of glass, probably the stem of a wine glass, and it went through my foot and I had to have surgery. And he's like on crutches for the next 3 weeks. I know. And he like posted a little
picture. How is the glass of wine? Is it okay?
The wine's fine, I think. Well, because it was. So this is the thing. He showed the x-ray and you can see it's like a 2-inch piece of like a stem of wine glass just went right through his foot. Why was there a broken stem around him? I don't know. Why was it standing up perfectly? I don't know. Why did he step on it? I don't know. But here we are, and now I can't go to sassy.
Well, you know what? Sometimes you step on glass.
And this affects me, and I'm the victim here.
I once, when I was 18, drunkenly drank a lot of Zima. I don't know if you guys know what Zima is.
I ordered a Zima, not an emphysema. Please don't smoke around me. Yeah, Zima. It was like Mike's Hard Lemonade.
But it was clear. Yeah.
It was like alcoholic.
So we drank a lot of it.
Gross.
And I was with some high school friends and we were in the Cape. And this.
What part of the Cape?
We were actually down the street from Kurt Vonnegut's house, which when you're 18.
Yarmouth?
And you love. Dennis? Was it Dennis?
Dennisport.
Yarmouth?
You know, you love Kurt Vonnegut and you drink a bunch of Zima, you think, let's go to Kurt Vonnegut's
house. I'm living
the
life. Yeah, let's go.
So we did. We walked over to Kurt Vonnegut's house and then there were dogs. So we promptly ran away back to the house where this guy we were with broke the window pane of the door. And I just, you know, stepped right over it to get another drink and then proceeded to drip blood all over her mother's beautiful Cape house, which I just like.
Were there rugs or was it hardwood?
Well, first of all, who puts carpeting in a Cape house?
That's wrong.
White.
That's
when you're on the beach.
That is wrong.
That's her stupid.
That
decision.
Sounds like a her problem for sure.
Yeah. So I definitely
dripped some blood, and somebody said, "Who's bleeding?" And then I scolded everybody about how this is our friend's house. And
but it was fucking you.
It was me. There was a puddle at my foot. And
Helen, come grab a mic, some headphones.
Since it was 2000, no, it wasn't 2000. It was 1999. I put out my wound with a cigarette because that's how they did it in Braveheart.
Oh my God, that's,
and in my Zima infused mind, that was a good decision.
That's such a terrible decision.
It was very painful, guys, as it turns out.
How high have you been ever? Like, what's the highest you ever got?
I smoked hash oil once with my brother.
Ew.
And actually, this is a good story because I got an immediate migraine.
excuse me, I get migraines. Episode 19, I get migraines.
And I couldn't move. And then I saw a commercial. I was like in the fetal position on my parents' floor watching TV, really freaking out. And I saw like a pudding commercial. My brother comes in. He's like, "Oh, are you all right? Like, oh my God, I'm so sorry." I was like, "No, I really wish I had some pudding though." And it turns out somebody brought pudding and he gave me a pudding cup.
What?
Do you know how awesome it is?
What do you mean somebody brought pudding?
He invited these people over, one of his friends.
And they brought you pudding?
And I was like
Jello pudding with the little vanilla stripe?
You know Cosby before he was creepy? Before we knew he was a rapist?
Yeah, pre-molester Cosby.
Do you know how awesome it is to get a chocolate pudding cup when you're high as fuck?
Totally. Oh my God.
And then it appears in front of you?
Guys, that's so funny you say that because my husband, Matthew, every time I ask him if he needs anything from the world, you know, like, "Oh, we're coming home. I'm coming home. Do you need something? Do you need something from the world? A soda or a polar seltzer, blah, blah." He always says, "Chocolate cake." And I'm like, "That's cute, but I'm never actually going to bring him chocolate cake, right?" But then I was like at the store and I was like, "Oh, but we're trying to lose a little weight." And I was like, "But maybe I could get him some pudding."
Yeah.
And I almost did, but then I was like, "But does everyone like pudding as much as I like pudding?"
Because why wouldn't
I love chocolate pudding.
Oh my God, I love chocolate pudding.
I think chocolate pudding is like one of the best things you can possibly bring to someone.
Yes, agreed.
Like a surprise.
Really?
Like, yeah, because I think it's one of those things that people are like, "Well, I love it, but like I
would never
have that
for myself."
Yeah,
I would never go out and
so
purchase
someone,
that.
Yeah, no. It to you, and, yeah, and it's like someone that you like care about.
Oh, basically, it's the best gift anybody can get you, Helen.
Like, wow, you like really understand me. You know?
Now we know we're getting Helen for her birthday. We're just gonna show up with a bunch of pudding cups.
Yeah, now we know.
I'm not joking.
I'll love you forever.
The 5-year wedding anniversary chocolate pudding.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
Allison's about to pukey bukey, so
I know.
I think we're gonna wrap it up.
Yeah.
Any closing thoughts, opinions, concerns?
Thank you for having us.
Thank you. I had such
a
good
gosh.
Time. We had such a fun day. And guys, I do get migraines, so I'm gonna have to ask you to leave.
I know, right?
And it's a wrap.
Until next time, listeners. Bye.
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 Bye. Bye. Bye.
Yeah.
I like the way your body moves. I like the way you spread confusion. I like the way my heart is booming. On and on, you'll never be mine. Never be mine. I'll be waiting. No, you'll never be mine. I know. You'll never be mine. I know. Yeah, you'll never be mine.
Yeah.
Body moves. I like the way you spread confusion. I like the way my heart is blooming.
You'll never be mine. Never be mine. No, you'll never be mine. Never be mine.